अस्सलामुअलैकुम नाज़रीन, वेलकम टू रियलिटी बाई सेट अराउंड 360। आपकी होस्ट किरण अली आपको आज के प्रोग्राम में खुश आमदेद कहती है। माज़रत चाहती हूँ, कुछ अरसे गायब रही, कुछ मजबूरियाँ थी उसकी वजह से, लेकिन आज का प्रोग्राम आपकी सारी शिकायत दूर कर देगा। जैसे हमेशा हम सोशल इशूज़ पर बात करते हैं, एक बहुत बड़ा इशू जो हमारी कम्यूनिटी फेस करी, जब मैं हमारी कम्यूनिटी की बात करती हूँ तो मैं बात करती हूँ साउथ एशियन मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी की। हमारी कम्युनिटी जो एक बहुत बड़ा इशू फेस कर रही है आजकल, जो मैंने बारहा मुख्तलिफ प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे लोगों को बात करते हुए देखा है, डिस्कस करते हुए देखा है, आज सोचा उस बारे में हम बात करें। इशू क्या है? फैमिलीज को प्रॉब्लम फेस कर रहे हैं अपने बच्चों की शादी करने में। ऐसा क्यों है जानते हैं, लेकिन उससे पहले जैसे मैं हमेशा अपना प्रोग्राम एक कोट से स्टार्ट करती हूँ, एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग कोट मैंने पढ़ा, पसंद आया, सोचा आपसे शेयर करूँ आज। इट सेज, व्हाट इज मैरिज? मैरिज इज डिफाइंड एज अ लाइफ लॉन्ग यूनियन बिटवीन टू इंडिविजुअल्स फॉर द प्रोपगेशन ऑफ द रेस, फॉर देयर म्यूचुअल हेल्प एंड सोलेस, एंड फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ इनेबलिंग देम टू वर्क आउट टूगेदर देयर हैप्पीनेस बोथ हियर एंड हियर आफ्टर। इन अ मैरिज you are the key of happiness or unhappiness of your partner. देखते हैं ये कितना सच है। हमारे साथ आज मौजूद है यास्मीना मेनन। यास्मीना कौन है? मैं इनको नहीं जानती थी, आई फाउंड हर थ्रू फेसबुक। स्पेशली जब बहुत सारी खवातीन हम खवातीन बहुत मुश्किल से किसी भी क्रेडिबिलिटी को बहुत मुश्किल से एक्सेप्ट करते हैं, तो जब मैंने देखा कि बहुत सारी खवातीन किसी एक खातून की तारीफ कर रही हैं या उनसे एडवाइस सीख कर रही हैं या उनसे मदद मांग रही हैं, तो मुझे यकीन था ये कुछ ना कुछ तो ऐसा कर रही हैं जो कम्युनिटी का बेटरमेंट का सबब बन रहा है। यास्मीना एक एंटरप्रेन्योर है, हज और उमरा कंसल्टेंट भी हैं, बट उसके साथ साथ जो एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट काम कर रही हैं वो एक फेसबुक ग्रुप चला रही हैं, मुस्लिम मैट्रिमोनियल कनाडा, जिसके 16 से 17 हज़ार मेंबर्स हैं। इट इज अ रजिस्टर्ड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। अस्सलाम वालेकुम यास्मीन, हाउ आर यू?
वालेकुम अस्सलाम करण, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड। अच्छा, टेल मी, व्हाई डिड यू इवन गेट इनटू इट? आई मीन, आई हैव सीन पीपल हु वुड टर्न अराउंड एंड से, व्हाट्स इन इट फॉर मी, और व्हाई डू आई टेक समवन एल्सस रिस्पांसिबिलिटी, और व्हाई डू आई इवन केयर? व्हाई डू यू केयर? व्हाई डिड यू स्टार्ट दिस?
I really don't know. It may be Allah had made me a zariya for this. Mm. Because when I started this program, it was 8 to 10 years back. Mm. And I would just connect family and friends. Mm. And then I saw over a period of time that people were really benefiting from my services. Mm. So I started this group, which was Muslim Matrimonial Canada. I volunteered with so many organizations first to learn how they were doing. And then I tried to correct the flaws that these organization has with the work that I was doing.
So you did not reinvent the wheel. You just learned from someone else's mistake and you decided
and
not to do that.
I corrected the mistake in my organization.
In your own capacity.
Yes.
Okay. Achha ji. It's a tough task. It's a tough task. Making two people come together. Not two people. It's like two families come together and then meet. I'm sure it's a very tough task. Are you doing it alone?
It's a very difficult task. I did it alone for many years.
Okay.
But now I have my husband.
Alhamdulillah.
He also helps me. And he's there as a strong support.
Achha.
As they say, you know, behind every successful man, there is a woman. In the same way, in my case, this was a hobby and a passion that I developed.
Mm.
And alhamdulillah, I can say the success also goes to my husband for being there to support me.
Mm.
Because this is what I do when I'm free.
Mm.
And late at nights and weekends. So alhamdulillah, I have to have his support to make this a successful program.
True that. Do let me know, how does the entire process work?
It's very simple. What I do is I collect my database from different places, like for example masjids. I have my flyers put up over there. I go to marriages, I go to weddings, I go on social media, Twitter, I go everywhere. And I say I'm a marriage consultant, and I help people make their marriages happen. This I realized because I was finding a very big chunk of youth who really did not know whom to communicate with. And they were a lot of families were being scammed by matchmakers.
Oy.
Yes, there are a lot of matchmakers who take a registration fee of like $500 from these people, and next day they don't even take their calls.
Okay.
And when they take their calls, they are very rude to these people.
Mm.
And alhamdulillah, I am an MBA with marketing and, you know, MBA with marketing and sales. And I have been into customer service for many years. And being a simple Muslim makes the difference.
True.
Our religion first teaches us to be humble,
humble
and courteous to people, which I found because of the money that involved. Believe me, matchmakers in Canada have made a lot of money because they have basically cheated people, which I did not look at from that point of view. My perspective was help as many families. So it says, you know, Allah gives you barakah based on your niyyah.
Yeah.
So alhamdulillah, my niyyah was very clean. And even today I help people. When they send their profiles to me, it is like I take their profile, I edit it. Like I remove all personal information from it. I post it on my Facebook group, giving it a number.
Okay.
Now, if somebody likes that profile, they email me and they say, Sister Yasmin, can we have the number of this profile that we liked? So I share these contact information with families.
Okay.
So this way families, more and more families, and with the successes that happen, believe me, there's very little advertising that I do. It's the word of mouth that brings people to me.
Yeah. It's a service that you offer. When the service is good, the quality is good, people do spread that. You don't need any marketing for that. Acha. The interesting thing is I posted a question on Facebook on various groups. And the question was, what are the problems that our South Asian Muslim community is facing when they plan to get their children married? And the outpour was tremendous. It was immense. It was like, you know, women just were just waiting for this. And I got all sorts of rejoinders over there. People were upset. Some were not. And then, you know, some blamed the boys' family. Some blamed the mom, the girls' family. And it went on and on and on. A few interesting points that I picked from there, and I will be sharing here. I do have their consent of sharing it here, so I will be sharing it with you, and let's then hear from you what have you gone through the same thing and how do you handle that. So the first thing is they say that majority of the people have a huge emphasis on physical appearance. They want the girl to be fair, they want the girl to have a stick figure, she should be tall, she should be pretty. And then, and professional too, young and professional too. And then some of them don't want her to be too religious. Some of them think that, you know, they want people from certain background, Urdu speaking ho, yeah, Punjabi speaking ho, and if she's Punjabi, then particular area of Punjab ho, or stuff like that. And then, the age matters a lot. And then there was a question where a girl said that I really don't understand why women want their sons to go back home and get married and not, you know, want girls from here, Canadian girls, because they think that either they're not very respectful or they're not too religious. Now this is, you know, just something that I picked up. It goes on and on and on. What do you have to say?
Basically, I would divide these issues into two parts. One is focused on the individual and the other is on the society.
Okay.
So when an individual lives in a society, we would just say that this is the individual, then comes the society. That
okay.
First is family and friends, and then you have the social circle of yours, which is like the community that you move in. So the Muslim Ummah that we are looking at. The social issues that you are talking about are exactly what I have got a feedback on.
Okay.
Like every mother of a girl comes and says that ladke ki maa ko to slim, gori, beautiful ladki chahiye.
Yeah.
Like hoor dhoond rahe apni bahu.
Yeah.
Apni bahu mein, they are looking for a hoor, angel, sort of figure. Now, I would say that is not really
true
because every person cannot be perfect.
Yeah.
When you go with this, now this is coming from the mothers, but actually I found when I actually meet the
boys.
They are not looking for perfection.
No.
I find they're very mature, the boys by themselves.
Yeah.
Whereas the mothers are putting a definite personality trait that they're looking for, the boys are not doing the same. In fact, I have seen when I have put a girl's picture. Now your people need to understand there is a big difference when you put a picture in front of a family and you actually meet the person.
Because the meet in person.
Like
yes.
The person is not photogenic.
Yeah.
Now, it happens, alhamdulillah, with me too. I am very shy of pictures. I don't like to take pictures. I move away because I really don't look good in pictures. But when somebody meets me, it would be a different personality.
Yeah.
So, the issues that we are talking about right now are social issues. One is physical related. The second is cultural related. So, social issues, if we are trying to face the social issues, we have to have a change of attitude. And this attitude change comes over a period of time. So the physical issues we're talking about,
it's there.
A girl, it exists in this society.
Okay.
And I think the mothers need to seriously think about it. But I have met these few women who have been very different from the others. Like these few women have said, alhamdulillah, meri bahu to healthy hai. And when I saw her, she was healthy and I didn't mind it at all.
Yeah.
So these are women who are very realistic.
Yeah.
Secondly,
no, but then, you know, you're talking probably after the marriage, you know, one. That, you know, she's been
no,
there,
no,
she said, no.
There are a few women who have said, yes, when I went to see the girl, she was already healthy and I accepted her as my bau.
Okay.
So, alhamdulillah, and I really relate to this because I've always been healthy. I've never been a slim trim girl.
Me too.
And there's nothing wrong. Alhamdulillah, I have lived a 25 years married life.
Yeah.
And my husband till date is happy with me. So, I don't know he ever looked for a slim trim girl. So, this is a very totally different concept.
So you feel that it's the mothers and not the sons. Who want a model for themselves.
Yeah, but then again, you know, they say, until there is no fire, there's no smoke. The son, when the mother must be asking him, aap kaisi ladki dekh raha, dubli patli, this is the way of saying it.
So tell me one thing, do you even think that when mothers decide that they want their son or their daughters to get married, they speak to them? They have an idea, do they even have an idea of who their son is or who their daughter is and what would be compatible? Do you think that they do have an idea?
This is a very good point, actually, because I do not understand how much of generation gap exists between parents and their children now. And this is very big because today, if you see the generation, I'm talking about the generation which is now 40 to 60 years old.
Yeah.
They have young grown-up children who are now looking to settle.
Yeah.
Being back home from Pakistan or India, we're talking about people have not been very open with their children.
Yes.
Or there has been the education in Canada, the society in Canada, which they have grown up in. They have gone to colleges and universities. And parents have a conservative background. The children have been growing up in a Canadian
society. In a liberal society, yeah.
So there's bound to be a big difference between these two. I really couldn't fathom till now how many parents actually talk to their children.
Yeah.
But I don't think too many parents do. I would give a ratio of 50-50 because some parents really discuss and talk with their children. When they talk to me, they say, "Humne apne bachche se baat ki," and my son said like this, my daughter, and I look for these signs when I talk to them. So I realize that, yes, some parents do talk and some parents just come outright and say, we are looking for this, and you have to find this type of a boy or a girl for my child. So I can say it's a 50-50.
Achha. Okay, now coming to the ones who talk to their children. Do you think they would understand where the child is coming from, or once they listen to them and then they might want to sway the child from what he wants and try to convince that, nahi nahi beta, you know, achhi ladki honi chahiye, khubsurat honi chahiye, bachche, and you know, I understand where they're coming from, because agar gori nahi hogi to tum bhi kaale ho, bachche bhi kaale honge. यह लंबी नहीं हुई तो सोचो क्या होगा, यह खूबसूरत नहीं हुई तो तुम्हारे बच्चे होंगे. यू नो दिस, आई हैव सीन पेरेंट्स डूइंग दैट. डू यू थिंक दैट हैपेंस?
इट डज हैपन, यस. आई हैव रियलिस्टिकली सीन दैट इन अ सिचुएशन, इन एन इवेंट वेयर यू नो अ बॉय एक्चुअली लाइक्ड अ गर्ल, द मदर लिटरली पुल्ड हिज हैंड एंड सेड, आई नीड टू टॉक टू यू. वेयर द बॉय इज सेइंग, आई इंसिस्ट, आई लाइक दिस गर्ल मॉम, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू मूव अ सेकंड स्टेप. वेयर द मदर सेज, नो, वी नीड टू टॉक अबाउट इट. आई मीन, you know what I'm trying to say? It's like mother putting her pressure.
Yeah. A parent in control over there.
The control mechanism comes into play, saying that, you know what, we come from this society and this is what we are looking forward to. This is a wrong step that you're taking. I don't know how many boys or girls actually bend down to the rule put by their parents. But I don't blame the parents also, because the parents have come with a certain amount of upbringing. So this discussions that we are talking about, which parents and children should have, is very important when the children are growing up, as you know, from teenagers to youth. These discussions should constantly happen with parents and children.
Yeah. I understand what you're saying. I have a son, mashallah, he's 16 now. I have started speaking to him now about girls and stuff, and he does talk to me about, you know, if he likes somebody, he would tell me that, you know, and I would ask, why do you like that person? What's the quality that you appreciate and that makes you attract towards that person? And we have all sorts of, we have a very open relationship, me and my son, alhamdulillah. But over here, I have a question, and I would really want to ask this question to the mothers. If you think that your son is not capable of deciding, or your daughter is not capable of deciding who the right person is to be married to, then do you even think that they're ready for marriage? Think about it. Achaji, a very interesting thing, somebody shared a story. I will read that out over here, and then we'll take it from there. So much to say. She says, once uncle and auntie came from my sister's proposal, and then they ended up asking, why are we renting a house? And then he said, rent ke paise to garbage ja rahe hain. I can never forget. Like, are you serious? So I know it happens, you know, when especially, you know, being a mother of a son, you do have that sense of superiority. You do feel that, you know, you're better, and that, you know, you have an edge, and then you're going and you're judging someone's family, you're judging the daughter, you're judging the family, you're judging even the house that they dwell in. Does that still happen? I mean, I thought it used to happen back in our days, but does that still happen?
It does, because this I get as a feedback from candidates themselves.
Hmm.
My father is a taxi driver, but I don't want you to say that in front of people.
Hmm.
When the rishta comes, you know, because they may reject the rishta because my father is a taxi driver.
Hmm.
And that's actually very shocking. Shouldn't be happening in a society like us.
Yeah.
Because end of the day, it's the girl that you're going to marry.
Hmm.
It's not the parents that you're going to
marry.
Yes, I totally agree that marriages do happen in our society, is not with the individual but with the family.
It's with the family,
you
yeah.
know, but it's important. But then I want the society to understand that the parents that they're talking about may be those parents who came on immigration here, did not get the right opportunities, and had to find their life or their earning in some other profession besides
True.
Their own.
True.
Like they say, you know, the best place to have heart attacks or a baby is in taxis in Toronto.
Yeah.
Why? Because the doctors from back home are driving those taxis.
Yeah. Yeah.
The same way that, you know, we should not be judging.
I know a lot of engineers were driving trucks over here.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, including my husband. He was also a truck driver.
Yeah.
He met with an accident a year back, and today he's supporting, I mean, he's like literally at home. You know, doing nothing, and he gets so depressed, so frustrated, and that's when I told him, getting, you know, involved with me. This is one way of you emotionally supporting people who look, and he's excellent, he's good at customer service, he knows how to talk to people. So that's how I got him, you know, at least helping me out as just a support system. But he's an engineer by profession. But he did not get. I came as an MBA, and I was a professor back home. I did not get the job that I wanted. I wanted to go back into teaching. It never happened.
Yeah.
So I got into as a Hajj and Umrah consultant. Alhamdulillah, I'm very happy.
Okay.
The company that I work for is excellent. The owners are excellent, you know, of the company that I work for. But then this is what I'm trying to say, is most of the parents are the immigrant parents like me, who opt for other options to take care of their children. So this should not be on which the parents should be judged.
Okay. Is it still the same, like, you know, the boy's family visit the girl's family, or is there, you know, things have changed now?
When I started 8-9 years back, it was still the families asking, oh, we're going to meet the girl's family at home, or we're going to visit the girl. And then I started seeing that people, you know, visiting other families was like, you know, daawat lag rahi thi. People would come, eat, and go, and then say no to the girl.
Yeah.
And that was really hurting when I was talking.
That feeling of rejection is bad.
Rejection was very bad.
Yeah.
So I started this trend where I said, you know what, you don't have to meet up at home. Meet up at Tim Hortons. Meet up at Starbucks. Meet up at, you know, Paneera Bread. Meet up at any place where you're comfortable. Because there you're not spending too much of money. Again, if you go to a restaurant, don't select an expensive restaurant. And don't order the full meal for a family that's coming, because you're spending like $300.
Yeah.
So if you're looking at meeting 10 boys' families, $3,000 are gone.
Yeah.
So my suggestion to every family, and I've seen this happening over a period of time, meet up outside. Make it very casual. most of the families, I think 90%, and I take this up as social issues on my group.
Yeah.
And most of the families, 90% agreed with me, but there was that 5 to 10% which always said, you know what, हमारे culture में ये बताया गया है कि you know मेहमान घर पे बरकत लाते हैं. तो you know, and we have grown up with that culture, and we would like that culture to continue.
That's okay, but if that has an impact on your child, then I think there is no barka in it.
There
is no barka in it. Yeah. Acha, suppose you know the families meet and they think that yes, I mean it might work out. Then how does it happen? Do they let the boy and the girl meet and decide? Do they let them go?
They do. I've seen this change happening over a period of time.
Good.
Earlier, it was like the parents would see the girl and boy and just show the
girl physical and boy appearance.
And it would be in a group, you know. But alhamdulillah, now what I have started is I started telling them, you know, let them meet.
Let them talk to each other.
Yeah. Give them time. If one meeting is not there, but make sure y'all are there, because you know what? Somewhere in the restaurant, you're sitting on another seat, and the boy and the girl are sitting on another seat. Because yes, I am conservative. People say you are conservative. Yes, I am conservative, because I do not believe that boy and girls should just meet alone. And but then there has to be certain amount of flexibility given to make this process happen. And if the generation, the way it has come up, and you know, I totally disagree if anybody says this is not a responsible generation. The generation that's here, there are a lot of parents who complain to me, no, they don't know how to make decisions. No, they know how to make decisions. I would say they know how to make decisions, and let them make their decisions.
Let them learn, even if they're making mistakes, it's okay.
Yeah.
So as Yasmina said, let them learn. They will learn through making mistakes. You're there to guide them, don't control them. Isi ke saath jaate hain, short break pe, don't go away, we'll be back short. Welcome back, Nazreen. ये अपना लास्ट सेगमेंट स्टार्ट करने से पहले एक और इंसिडेंट शेयर करूंगी. समबडी पोस्टेड दिस ऑन फेसबुक. इट वाज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी. शी सेड अनदर फनी स्टोरी टू शेयर अबाउट रिश्ता आंटीज. दिस आंटी इन माय नेबरहुड कॉल्स माय मॉम एंड सेज माय सिस्टर इन लॉ जस्ट वांट्स टू कम ओवर फॉर 10 मिनट्स. द लेडी डजंट कम हरसेल्फ, सेंड्स हर सिस्टर इन लॉ विद होल खानदान. ठीक है. सो आफ्टर दे कम एंड एंड स्टार्ट टॉकिंग, they tell me to take her son to another room. And then she said something, I can't read that. Some of my, so my mom says, no, I have to ask him some questions. My mom turns around to him and asks that if he is so educated and modern, why is he participating in the kind of behavior suddenly showing up to someone's house to see their daughter? He was sitting quietly with his head down. His mom says, oh, nahi, wo kahan tayyar tha? हम तो लड़की देखने के लिए आए थे, वो तो शादी 2 साल से पहले करना ही नहीं चाहता. एंड द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट इज दैट द बॉयज मॉम इवन हैड एन एंगेजमेंट रिंग इन हर पर्स इन केस के लड़की पसंद आ जाए. नाउ विद दिस हैपनिंग अराउंड, टेल मी हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज.
इट इज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन, because many a times I have received like a feeling both from the girl's side and from the boys. Now I'm not going to isolate this to a boy's case, because it's a girl who is
no I'm coming to the girl's side also,
because it's a girl who's actually relating the story, so she's saying her end, whereas I have got the story from the other side also, where you know, the boy's family has been calling up a girl's family, and they go to see the girl, and then the girl says, I'm still not ready for marriage. So why are parents pushing their children to take a step which they are not ready for?
I also know a family, the boy is 24, the girl is 19, she's studying. The girl's parents are telling them that she's not ready, she's too young, and the boy's family is insisting ki chale milne to de, hum dekhte hain. Now kitna arsa dekhna hai aapko? I mean, I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, but do you think that, you know, this dekhna of 2 years and 3 years, once you start knowing, when was the boy and the girl, I mean, I might be very orthodox, but mujhe lagta hai ki wo charm, you know, khatam ho jata hai. And then after 2-3 years, they come to a level that they might not even feel that connection with one another if they get to know each other too much before getting married.
There are two ways of looking at this. One is, I'm in the real world, so I know this is happening literally every day. One is where they say that hum engagement karke rakhte the, aur fir 2 saal ke baad inki jab padhai khatam ho jayengi to ye
to dekhenge
shaadi kar denge inki. दिस इज लाइक नो प्रॉमिस
बट
शादी कर देंगे
जस्ट टू हुक Just to somebody on the sure hook,
so that this boy does not go anywhere, or wo hook mein pakda hua hai. The same thing happens from the girls, but believe me, I have got a very bad feeling about this from both the ends.
Yeah,
what parents?
What percentage does end up in marriage?
That's what I'm trying to find out. Like, I mean, you know, there is another way of looking at it is nikah pada do. एक साल के बाद आप रुखसती करो
दैट इज द रॉन्ग
थिंग एज पर द इस्लामिक रूल
दिस
इज कि निकाह पढ़ाने के बाद ये बॉयज गर्ल्स मिल सकते हैं व्हिच इज इस्लामिकली फाइन फॉर देम एंड देन रुखसती व्हिच बेसिकली मींस दैट गर्ल स्टार्ट्स लिविंग विद द बॉय एज वाइफ
अच्छा चलो इन दैट केस अगर आपने निकाह पढ़ा दिया माय क्वेश्चन इज अगर आपने निकाह पढ़ा दिया और उसके बाद उन्होंने मिलना शुरू किया एंड देन दे रियलाइज दैट दे आर नॉट फिट फॉर वन अनदर तो फिर क्या होगा
But trust me, I've never seen a situation like this happen.
Achha,
the nikahs have happened and Ruksati is like after a year or so out of the, I would say, 20-25 marriages that I have seen, this is a very successful strategy rather than taking
the So do you think that because now they know ki ab to nikah ho gaya hai, they try and make the ends meet?
Exactly. So this is much more successful because Islamically the children know, believe me, it's like, yes, our
They try to work out the situation.
They try to work it out. Because they know that after 1 year I'm going to live with this person, so I better understand his habits, his
and more myself,
and more myself understand how I'm getting along with this person. So marriage is just not knowing the person, knowing the family, and what I've seen is this has really been successful as far as you know doing the nikah and doing the ruksati after some time makes more sense to family.
Achha, do you think that you know girls these days are have become more picky?
Yes.
They become very choosy, they become very stubborn. Canadian environment में जब हम जहाँ हम बच्चों को बहुत सारी चीजें सिखाते हैं हम उनको थोड़ा सा बदतमीज भी बनाते हैं अब दैट इज वॉट आई फील कि हमारे बच्चे अब पहले से ज्यादा बदतमीज हो गए हैं बदतमीज इन द सेंस के जो हम बहुत सारी बातें बड़ों की बर्दाश्त करते थे जब हम छोटे थे कि वो बड़े हैं अब वो फीलिंग खत्म हो गई है तो फिर बहुत सारी लड़कियां नहीं चाहती कि वो लड़के के घर वालों के साथ रहें बहुत सारी लड़कियों के माँ बाप का भी होता है कि अकेला हो तो अच्छा है छोटी फैमिली हो तो अच्छा है पढ़ा लिखा भी होना चाहिए अच्छे पैसे भी कमाने चाहिए अपना घर भी होना चाहिए और जी 30 से ऊपर नहीं होना चाहिए तो अब अगर वो स्पेल सेटल भी है और पढ़ा लिखा भी है और अच्छा घर भी है तो वो 30 से तो लामहाला ऊपर होगा ही और अगर वो नहीं है तो उसका मतलब है कि फिर माँ बाप के पैसे हैं तो जब वो माँ बाप के पैसों पे है तो फिर वो माँ बाप को कैसे छोड़ेगा तो यू टेल मी Is it true or have I exaggerated the situation over here?
No, I would first like to come to your point where girls have become very choosy and picky.
Okay.
Now, from what I understand is the age group has gone up over the years.
Yes.
Like in our times, we were married by the age of, between the age of 20 to 23. This was our age group to get married because we finished our graduation, then parents would get us married. Many of us did not even complete our graduation and we were married off.
Oh, I got married and very young.
Wanted, Like, I mean, I remember my days. Yeah. I had to fight with my mother for my education. Yeah. Like, mama, meri graduation hone do, meri
postgraduation.
And I had to prove myself at every point to gain those years to get married. And at the age of 22, I was told, you're very old now, you know.
Hai bichari ki nahi hui shaadi. I know the word bichari.
कजिन्स की शादी हो गई है तूने अभी तक शादी नहीं किया बेटा बदनाम हो रहे हैं हम लोग कम्युनिटी में ऐसा लग रहा है कि आप किसी को एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहे हो तो यू हैव टू नाउ गेट मैरिड एंड एट द एज ऑफ 23 आई वाज आस्क्ड टू गेट मैरिड नाउ अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह इट्स अ नाइस एज टू गेट मैरिड एंड आई वुड सजेस्ट टू एवरी पेरेंट ओवर हियर दैट 22 टू 23 इट्स अ गुड एज
फॉर द गर्ल्स
यस स्टार्ट योर प्रोसेस डू नॉट डिले दैट बिकॉज व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इन द जनरेशन नाउ इज They are coming out from their education at 27, 28.
Yes.
And by the time they finalize their marriage, they are already into 28, 29. So what is happening is there's like a reproduction phase. They are going very close to 30s.
Yeah.
And I would say in commercial terms, marketability is less.
Yeah.
But I still do not believe in this concept because if the girl's age is going more, so are the boy's age going more. Because jab hum settle ladke dhoond rahe is age group ke from 20, 25 to 30 ke beech mein ki ladkiyon ke liye, so we are looking for boys between 30 to 35 because they are looking for well settled boys.
Yeah.
Now again here there has to be an attitude change which alhamdulillah from my end I have been trying to do a lot. Like telling parents that, see your child is going through education and she's coming towards the end of education. You are a parent. You are the decision maker. हम अपने बच्चों को एक पेरेंट का दर्जा दे देते हैं डिसीजन मेकिंग
आस्क मी Don't do that.
You make your lines, draw your lines and say, beta, it's time to restart looking for you.
Yes.
At the age of 22, 23, start rolling the ball so that you can at least get a nine. And believe me, the change is coming.
Mm.
Earlier, I used to have all profiles above the age of 25.
Mm.
Like, I have 2,000 profiles with me right now. 2,000
Still with you.
With me. Mm. I get them married, yes. I refresh my database, yes.
Mm.
But I still have 2,000 profiles and they come in an age segment which is, I would say 75% of them are in this age group from 25 to 35.
And it is difficult to get them married?
It is difficult, but it is happening.
Okay.
So it's not impossible because the matchmakers, they straight away say that, you know what, aapki beti to 30 hai, to hum jo 500 charge karte, wo hum aapko 1,000 charge karenge.
Oh my God.
Yes. Oh, aapki beti to marketable nahi hai, ab kahan se main hum unke liye itna bada ladka do? And this is wrong.
Hmm.
I would tell the parents this is totally wrong. Hmm. Don't listen to such matchmakers and make your life difficult, get stressed.
Hmm.
There are nice boys and girls in that age group.
Yasmina, mujhe ye batao ki jaise hum ye dekhte hain ki Canada mein divorce rate bahut high hai. ठीक है वो बच्चे जिनके पेरेंट्स की डिवोर्स हुई हुई है. Is that a taboo to get them married? Is it difficult to get them married?
I've not seen that. Actually,
no. ऐसा नहीं होता?
Because there has been a change in thinking.
Okay.
You know what? I mean,
because I have seen
Indian community में इतना ज़्यादा नहीं है, but अरबों में बहुत ज़्यादा है. Arab community में, I've seen every alternate or every two couples के बाद it's a divorce case. But Indian Pakistani community में ये असर नहीं है डिवोर्स का जितना उन community. But still, the North American community, there's a big study on the Google. I was studying it, where they say this is a big issue in the Muslims of North America. Divorces, that's happening.
It is.
At a very big.
नहीं हमारी कम्युनिटी में भी हो गए.
Absolutely.
हमारी पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी में भी बहुत हैं. तो क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम आती है उनके बच्चों की शादियां कराते हुए या नहीं?
होती है, but not impossible. I do my best. Alhamdulillah, I have got so many divorced girls married. In fact, sitting here.
No, not divorced girls. एक तो है ना कि जिनकी खुद की डिवोर्स हुई हुई है उनकी शादी कराना. एक मैं बात कर रही हूँ कि माँ बाप की डिवोर्स हुई हुई है उनके बच्चों की शादी कराने में प्रॉब्लम आता है.
नो,
क्योंकि मैंने सुना है कुछ लोग ये कहते हैं कि जब इनके पेरेंट माँ ने ही घर नहीं चलाया तो बच्ची को क्या पता होगा, बेटी क्या सीखेगी, माँ सी तो सीखती है. इज दैट
मस्ट बी हैविंग अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ इंपैक्ट.
या बट नॉट टू एन एक्सटेंट. नेग्लिजिबल.
ओके,
ठीक है. अच्छा, नाउ डिवोर्स लड़कियों की शादियां या डिवोर्स लड़कों की शादियां.
Yeah, it's basically considered as what do you call a dhabba on that girl
taboo,
she's divorced.
A boy ka hai to sahi hai.
Boy ka hota hai to girls mothers are more acceptable.
Mm.
Divorce, oh, it's okay.
Because it's easy to blame the girl in every case.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now what my this thing is, I have got divorced girls and boys married. It hasn't been difficult.
Mm.
But you need to know the right people to help you out.
Mm.
Canada, you don't have the social family friends helping you out at that point. There are a lot of fee sabilillah organizations which are doing it.
Mm.
But the problem with the fee sabilillah organizations are nobody takes responsibility or accountability for you.
Mm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Nobody takes and says, this is my project.
Yeah.
This person has come to me for help and let me take it up as to help that person. Whereas, believe me, literally with 2,000 profiles I have, I know most of them by names, by their number, you know, like...
you know them in person.
Qualification, I know them in person, I've met the parents.
Mm.
So, alhamdulillah, it becomes so easy for me to match these people.
Achha, ek aur cheez maine dekhi hai, OSAP. Jin bachiyon ne OSAP liya hua hota hai. वो क्या इशू है? क्या उनके जो जब शादियों का होता है, मैंने जितना देखा है, वो लड़के वालों का ये कहना होता है कि भाई ये ओसैप पेरेंट्स क्लियर करेंगे, हम नहीं करेंगे.
They are not actually supposed to clear that OSAP. It's the girl who basically has educated herself and she doesn't mind clearing it over the
year. But वो तो उस केस में ना कि when you let her work, if you're not even letting her work, how will she clear that off?
The situation has changed today.
Okay.
They are all looking for earning daughter-in-law.
अच्छा, okay. चलो.
Because you know what, they're getting used to a second income.
हाँ.
You know what I'm saying? Their standard of living has risen so much that the wife working has become a very important part of this segment. So you're looking like if you want to give good education to your children, drive the best of cars, have the best of homes, then you need to have a wife supporting your income. Now, I am not very happy with this concept because I feel if a girl wants to be a homemaker, she should be. And I'm not finding any girl who says, I just want to be a homemaker. I'm not finding a girl like that. Can you believe it? Who says, I want to be a homemaker.
Achha, mujhe yahan kisi ne post kiya tha. I thought of not reading it, but I will read it. This has brought. I even know of three girls whose in-laws are upset when they heard the news of pregnancy because काम कौन करेगा?
ट्रस्ट मी, दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. I mean,
Okay.
I have never.
And then she went on writing, I've heard mother-in-laws at parties say now that this generation of girls want to exclusively breastfeed because they just want to sit in the room the entire day and have fun. No.
This is probably
a niche.
A very small issue that's happening. But alhamdulillah, one more change of a segment is, I have seen that mothers are now training their boys to do household work. Which is big change, which never happened back home. We serve food to our husbands, our brothers. We were trained by serving food to our brothers
and fathers,
so that we serve our husbands.
Garam garam wo bhi, garam roti, yes, it's
totally
changed.
Changing now.
Yes.
The younger generation is more responsible. They're in fact a very good support system for their wives. Like I know I have been different, alhamdulillah, my husband, he always, like when I go, the cup of tea that I'm served in the evening is made by my husband. Trust me, I mean, morning when we get up, we have tea together. Evening when I come back from work, we have tea together. So I'm among those lucky ones, and I never have to cook. I mean, he cooks the meals for himself. He says, "Tum mere liye tension mat le."
Housewife.
He is that sort of. Now everybody may not be that lucky.
Yeah.
A girl should learn cooking because that is a requirement out here of the families, basically the South Indian families.
Acha. This is another thing that I read, and I'll read it out. I was at an event some time ago. I was seated with three beautiful Muslim girls. They seemed to be in their late 30s. All of them very highly educated from top universities in Canada and highly paid jobs. After an initial conversation, I was surprised when they candidly shared that they were there to look for a mate. They said that in their teenage and their adult years, they were not allowed to mingle with young male Muslims. They had seen the marriages of their friends or sisters to cousins imported from back home fail miserably and were not ready to marry an unknown guy from a foreign land. Ab is case mein kya? Aur phir wo aage likhte hain, now their parents couldn't find a suitable suitor for them, so they have taken up the mission themselves as they didn't want to end up old maids. This made me really sad. The incident epitomizes the dilemma of marriages today in Canada. Now they're talking about late 30s.
You know, I have some candidates who are in their late 30s. The sad part is that you do not have. I would say I do not have too many profiles
of male
of males who are still waiting in their late 30s to marry these
or 40s.
Or 40s to marry these girls, because what has happened is they have already finished one round of marriage, got divorced, and now coming back, and there is this segment which is sitting out there which needs a family. So then they look at these girls in late 30s and say, okay, is there a girl that I would like to get married to? You know what I'm
saying? A divorced man.
A divorcee man is the option that is.
अच्छा मुझे ये बताओ, I was just sitting with my friends and we were. एक जोक हम क्रैक कर रहे थे एंड वी लाइक के इतनी सारी डिवोर्स औरतें हमें नजर आती हैं, इनके हस्बैंड्स कहाँ गए हैं, उनकी भी तो डिवोर्सेस हुई होंगी. व्हाट हैपेंस, आई मीन आई हैव फिगर्ड आउट के जब डिवोर्सेस हो जाती है तो द मेन वुड गो बैक, गेट मैरिड बैक होम एंड देन कम हियर. सो वी हैव मोर एंड मोर सिंगल वुमेन ओवर हियर देन सिंगल मेन. इज इट ट्रू?
इट्स हैपनिंग एक्चुअली.
या
अ लॉट ऑफ मेन व्हेन दे गेट मैरिड ओवर हियर दे गो थ्रू दिस डिवोर्स, एंड इफ इट इज अ गर्ल फ्रॉम कनाडा इटसेल्फ, लाइक a girl who has gone over here and the divorce is with her, they say, oh, you know what,
ye to Canadian thi,
yeah, the Canadian thi, now I'm going to go back home and get married with a simple girl and come back. In fact, in Canada I met a man like who came to register with me and he says, baji, you know, mere ko virgin chahiye. I said, aap virgin ho?
Yes.
You have divorced and come back.
Yeah,
that means you have spent your life and you have now in late 30s you're coming to marry a. I said, please, I'm not looking for people like you, and do not call me again. I caught a person like that. They lie on their profiles.
Yes.
And
yes, the lies, yes.
Because I'm so sharp in my hearing. If somebody says once I'm 38 and then he says next time when he talks to me or sends a profile 35, I don't forget. My memory is so sharp. So I say, you know what? I mean, when I last
you're lying,
you were 35, 38, now you're saying...
And if you're lying in the beginning, then...
Exactly.
Yeah.
And this is again another Facebook issue that I brought up in my group, and I said, never ever tell lies.
Yeah.
Because when you start your marriage with a lie, what will happen for the rest of your life? So do not start your
marriage. And to cover up a lie, you will keep lying for your entire life.
No, there is a big segment of people who are getting divorced, who are coming back, but... marriages are happening, but they need some sort of a support system to get back into a family life a stable.
अच्छा यास्मीना, अब ये तो सारे हमने problems identify की, solutions क्या हैं?
I would have put this down very simply in two, three sentences. One,
of
parents and the children.
Both, okay.
Because the major issue that I have seen in parents is we want the girl from the same culture.
हाँ.
And believe me, I mean.
अच्छा सेम कल्चर से ज्यादा पाकिस्तानी तो हो, पाकिस्तान में भी पंजाबी हो, डू स्पीकिंग हो, सराइकी, फिर पंजाब से भी सराइकी हो, मतलब इतने मेटिकुलस हो जाते हैं हम उसके अंदर.
इट्स लाइक यू नो मैं पंजाब से हूं, आई वांट ओनली अ लाहौरी, एंड आई वाज, एंड देन शी गिव्स मी अ सेगमेंट लाइक मेरी बेटी से सिर्फ 2 साल या 3 साल बड़ा हो. नाउ आई हैव गॉन थ्रू माय एंटायर प्रोफाइल दैट आई हैव गॉट एंड गेटिंग दैट स्मॉल सेक्शन सेगमेंट ऑफ पीपल वॉइस फॉर दिस गर्ल वाज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी. सो व्हाट आई टेल पेरेंट्स इज ओपन अप. Until the society doesn't. For example, Pakistani doesn't want to marry an Indian family doesn't want to marry a Pakistani. But end of the day, we are all Muslims.
वो visa issue होता होगा जाने में फिर.
नहीं. They bring up the visa issue.
Thing.
But tell me,
yeah.
How many times have you gone on the visa back home? How many Pakistani and Indians are going back? I'm an Indian. I have gone only once back home, 10 years in Canada, and I've only gone back once home. So how many of us are actually going back home every year and saying, oh, Pakistan mein issue ka, you know,
visa ka issue
ka. I don't think we should look at this as an issue. We should look at it as Muslims and be open to other communities.
Okay.
There are a lot of boys and girls who are revert who are coming into our community. Be open to revert. Alhamdulillah, I mean, 25 years back, my husband was a Hindu. I married him and he accepted Islam and then he proposed to me. My son-in-law is a Chinese who has accepted Islam and I married my daughter to him. Because jab wo Allah ke samne jhuk raha hai, I don't need anything beyond.
Aur hame acceptable unko karna chahiye.
I'm acceptable. Because, you know, as husband and wife, you get through all the hurdles that come. So, one is change of, as I said, parents ke attitude mein change hona chahiye. Accept divorced boys and girls. Yeah, exception, when you accept divorce boys and girls, I always say give the benefit of doubt to these boys and girls. You don't know the reason why they got.
अच्छा एक तो मुझे ये समझ नहीं आता कि divorce हो गई, ठीक है हो गई, जरूरी नहीं है कि any one of them has to be evil. Things did not work out between them.
Exactly. You know what I mean? If they study, I mean, divorces in Islam and why our Prophet allowed us to do this, they will realize that humans are not perfect. Kya reason ho sakta hai, we don't know.
True.
You know, and these girls, like when I got in January, a girl got married who was divorced and they invited me for the nikah. Most of these families invite me. There are some who feel ashamed that they have got married through a marriage consultant or whatever I put it as. So they don't even invite me for the nikah, but I would say it's a shame because this person has found a mate for your child. The child will now live the life and you do not want to forget about giving a gift check to the person. You know, forget about giving some gifts like how they do back home. You don't even call that person for nikah and I feel really bad. I feel really hurt. But the thing is, I say, you know what? I don't know their reasons. And I say, yeah, Allah guide them to the right path because I'm not a judge out here to anybody. But the situation has to change for our society because accepting divorced boys and girls is very important part of this society. Fourthly, judge your children, talk to them, communicate with them, find out what they want. And this is a very short like solution is understanding your children based on that look for spouses. Don't, you're not looking for yourself. The parents need to understand they are not looking for spouses for themselves. They are looking for their children. So, just like for example, I tell everybody this example. Meri beti, I come from India. I speak 5-6 languages. Meri beti to sirf English bolti hai. And her Urdu is the Canadian type of Urdu. So can I get her married to somebody who speaks the same language or ask for my state? I cannot. I have to look at those boys and girls who have grown up in this environment. And trust me, I have seen that I have the profiles are 90% Canadian children. There must be just like 5% who are looking to bring their brothers or sisters from back home. Those profiles also I have, and I encourage people to do that because, see, end of the day, I'm a Muslim, and I want these boys and girls who are sitting back home to come to their relatives and their family who are already settled here. Like I just got married a girl from Faisalabad, whose entire family had come on immigration out here, and she was sitting out there alone, and that family approached me and said, "Yasmin Baji, can you help?" And I went out of my way to find a boy for that girl, and now she's already in Canada.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. You know, so I have a lot of fan following from Faisalabad, and I don't know the reason why. So Alhamdulillah.
That's nice. That's nice.
You know, experiences that I come across.
Okay, that's great. Acha, if there is a message that you would want to give your audience,
I would just like to say that alhamdulillah, I'm very thankful that I'm here today. I'm honored, Kiran, to be part of this show. And I would tell parents that have certain amount of flexibility when you're looking for children to settle your children. But the boys and girls have sabr, have patience, because marriage is not easy.
Yeah.
And make your marriages successful. Look at the compatibility criteria that you're looking for. Do not judge anybody, because alhamdulillah, none of us are perfect out here.
Yeah, true. Thank you, Yasmin. Thank you so much. नाज़रीन, उम्मीद करते हैं आज का प्रोग्राम आपको पसंद आया होगा। इसको पूरे को रैप अप करूंगी मैं, प्रॉब्लम्स पे तो नहीं जाऊंगी, हम सब जानते हैं हमारे आसपास क्या हो रहा है। मैं कुछ सॉल्यूशंस पॉइंट आउट करूंगी, जैसे यास्मीना ने बहुत अच्छी बात की कि इंस्टेड ऑफ हैविंग देम ओवर, अपने घर बुलाएं आप उनको, आप उनको किसी कॉफ़ी शॉप पर मिलें, आप अलग टेबल पर बैठ जाएं, बच्चों को अलग टेबल पर बैठने दें, लेट देम गेट टू नो ईच अदर। बाज़फ़ा होता है कि हम क्योंकि इस एज ब्रैकेट में हैं, हम अपने आपको कैमोफ्लाज कर लेते हैं, पेरेंट्स अपने आप को कैमोफ्लाज कर लेते हैं। जब बच्चे एक दूसरे से इंटरेक्ट करते हैं तो वो जल्दी असलियत जान जाते हैं। तो इस कोशिश करें कि बच्चों को मिलने दें, बात करने दें, अपनी नज़र के सामने ही सही बट बात ज़रूर करने दें। और अगर आप ये नहीं करना चाहते तो एक वो जो ट्रेडिशनल तरीका था ना कि पहले लड़की की तस्वीर आएगी, कोशिश करें दोनों तस्वीर एक्सचेंज की जाएँ। तस्वीर वैसे तो एक बहुत अच्छा तरीका नहीं होता, आप पर्सनालिटी नहीं जज कर पाते, लेकिन अगर आपका वो कल्चर है, आप नहीं चाहते कि आप पहले मिलें, तो फिर लड़की की तस्वीर अगर आप मांग रहे हैं तो साथ साथ अपने बेटे की तस्वीर ज़रूर भेजिए, क्योंकि जैसे आपका हक है लड़की को देखना, वैसे ही लड़की के माँ बाप का हक है वो लड़के को ज़रूर देखें। वो लड़की का भी उतना ही हक है कि वो ये जानें कि उसको देखने कौन आ रहा है, और क्या वो चाहती भी है कि वो बंदा उसको देखने आए भी या नहीं, ये विंडो शॉपिंग नहीं है। अपने बच्चों से ज़रूर बात करें, जाने कि क्या वो तैयार भी हैं एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी उठाने के लिए। बार दफ़ा ये होता है कि हमें ये लगता है कि हमारे बच्चे तैयार हैं वो एक जिम्मेदारी, और वो उस जिम्मेदारी को उठाने के लिए तैयार नहीं होते, वहाँ पे मसाइल पेश आते हैं। तो बच्चों से ज़रूर बात करें अपने, जानिए कि क्या वो तैयार भी हैं इस बड़ी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी को, ना कि इस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी में स्टेप इन करने के लिए, उसको निभाने के लिए भी, क्योंकि उसके लिए भी आपको अपने जहन को तैयार करना पड़ता है। अपने बच्चों को गाइड करें, कंट्रोल मत करें, अपनी मर्जी अपनी पसंद उन पे मुसल्लत ना करें। जिंदगी उन्होंने गुजारनी है, जानिए उनकी पसंद क्या है और उस हिसाब से लड़की या लड़का ढूंढिए। झूठ मत बोलिए, डोंट लाई, जो है जैसा है उसको वैसा ही बयान कीजिए। अगर किसी को आपका सच नहीं पसंद तो ये उनका प्रॉब्लम है, आपका नहीं है। आपको अल्लाह ताला इंशाल्लाह जरूर बरकत देगा अगर आप सच का साथ देंगे। झूठ के बिना पे जो रिश्ता होता है वो लॉन्ग लास्टिंग कभी नहीं होता, ठीक है। और आखिर में, रेज स्ट्रॉन्ग डॉटर्स एंड गर्ल्स एंड बॉयज बोथ। अपने बेटों को अपनी बेटियों को स्ट्रॉन्ग बनाइए, हकाइक का सामना करने वाला बनाइए। जब आप उनको स्ट्रॉन्ग और मच्योर बनाएंगे वो उसी वक्त उस पोजिशन में होंगे कि वे सही और गलत का फैसला कर सकें, और वो ये आइडेंटिफाई कर सकें कि एक फिजिकल अपियरेंस के को जब आप ट्रांसेंड करके आगे जाते हैं तो जो पर्सनालिटी है, क्या वो पर्सनालिटी उनके लिए या उनसे कंपैटिबल है या नहीं है। बाज़ दफ़ा बच्चे फिजिकल अपीयरेंस को देख के इतना अंडर प्रेशर या अंडर ओ आ जाते हैं, या फिजिकल अट्रैक्शन इतनी ज़्यादा होती है कि वो जो इंसान होता है पीछे वो उसको पहचान नहीं पाते। तो कोशिश करें, और ये सारी चीज़ें तभी होंगी जब आप अपने बच्चों से बात करेंगे, उनको बताएंगे, उनसे चीज़ों को छुपाएंगे नहीं। अगर आपके आसपास किसी की डिवोर्स हुई है तो बच्चों को ज़रूर बताइए कि डिवोर्स हुई है, क्यों हुई है, क्या असबाब थे, अगर वो असबाब ऐसे हैं जो आप बच्चों से डिस्कस सकें, ताकि बच्चों को पता हो कि हमारे आसपास क्या हो रहा है, क्या चीज़ें हैं जो बाय द एंड ऑफ द डे अगर हो तो गलत होती हैं, वो उन चीज़ों से सीखें ताकि वो गलतियां खुद ना कमिट कर सकें। ये छोटा सा था एक रीकैप जो इस पूरे अपने एपिसोड से हमने अख़्ज़ किया है, आपकी फेसबुक पोस्ट से पढ़ के अख़्ज़ किया है। उम्मीद करते हैं कुछ बहुत सारे सवाल नहीं तो कुछ सवालों के जवाब आपको आज इस एपिसोड से ज़रूर मिले हों। इसी के साथ हमारा एपिसोड अपने अख्ताम को पहुंचा। अगर पसंद आया डू राइट टू अस @realitybites@toronto360.tv या हमें कॉल करें 416-500-2424 पे। जैसे मैं हमेशा कहती हूँ, खुश रहिए, आबाद रहिए, अपने आसपास के लोगों का ख्याल रखिए। अस्सलाम वालेकुम।